Hey everyone, this is Mukesh Otwani once again from learn-innovation.com. Today in this video, I'm going to talk about how you can explain your framework in interviews, okay? This is a very frequently asked question in my comment box and via email as well, that how we can explain our framework in interviews. We know how we have created the framework, how this framework works, how we are creating the script, but we are not able to explain the proper way, or we are not able to, you know, explain them in a structured manner. So this is just a quick video how you can explain your framework. Now, before we move into the actual framework discussion, there are two kind of framework. One is the custom framework that you will be creating, right? You will be creating from the scratch. You will write your own utilities, you will create base classes, test scripts, and you will be running. Another way is like you can use some, you know, custom framework which is already available in the market as an open source. We have a Serenity framework, we have a Robot framework, we have Selenite, we have Catalyum, right? There's so many available set of framework in the market. So one option, you can download these frameworks, you can follow their rules and guidelines, you can start developing your scripts. Second is like create everything from the scratch, okay, and then consume it. So in interviews, they will not ask you to write everything, design framework in front of them. They just want to know whether you have the fair knowledge about your automation framework or not. The different component involves. In each component, what are the things you are using? So I'm going to explain you the same thing. I will first tell you what are the different components we have in automation framework, and for each component, what are the set of tools and libraries that you are using, okay? So now let's get started. So first of all, I will explain you the different components, and then each component, what are the things we're using, so that you can explain the same when you start attending interviews. So when you start designing the framework, okay, so we need to take care about the different components. So suppose this is your framework, or maybe I will start in this manner. I will just start from the scratch. So basically the first component, see again, there's no numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but these are the standard components you should maintain in your framework. So the first component, okay, or I will say one of the component is the test data, okay, that you will not hard code anything in your scripts. You will be maintaining the test data into a different file. So in future, if any test data changes, you don't need to modify your script. You just go and update the test data and your script should get updated with the correct data. Okay, this is the first rule. You should never hard code the data. Now in this part, we will be using Apache API properties file that I will show you. Second component is reporting and log. Okay, so now this reports can be in any form. You can have XML based report, JSON based report, HTML based report, right, PDF based report. So depends on which kind of report you're generating, you need to use the different set of libraries. And now if you're using the, you know, the latest report like extend report, elder report, you also get the logs along with the report. Okay, so don't need to use log4j separately, you will be getting logs along with the report. That also I will show you. Then you need utilities, right? Now these utilities is like common utilities which will save your code. I will say that it will like you will be writing some reusable code so that each and every test script can start using it. So the main purpose of keeping this utility, like these are project independent, okay? So tomorrow if you have some new project, or tomorrow you have new application that you want to automate, you can use these utilities. These utilities will include some common, I will say, methods, okay? Like you can have capture screenshot, you can have wait till the web element is not visible, wait till the element is not clickable, wait till this title is not present, okay? You can also keep some standard libraries, okay, which you will be using throughout your project. Then you have to use at least one of the unit test framework, right? So basically this will be part of the test script, so I'm just keeping it here. You have to use one of the unit test framework, so you have to use either JUnit or TestNG, right? You can explain that we are using one of the unit test framework called TestNG, and using this we are generating our test script. Okay, now this is the catchy part here. You need to explain this is the framework we are using. We are generating test script, and to generate the test script we are using one of the design pattern. So here now you need to introduce design pattern. So in design pattern, you can explain about the page object model. In the page object model, as we know, we will be creating different pages. Depends on how many HTML pages we have. Based on each page, we will create each Java class methods and we will be using. So in this test script component, you need to explain, we are using page object model, we are using unit test framework, which is TestNG. Then you need to explain that we are using Maven, which is again a build tool. Okay, so using Maven, we are taking care of the project dependencies, plus we are also running our test using Maven. Okay, so we just create a small build. Okay, and the moment we say mvn clean test, it runs our scripts. And now this is the main part, guys. Runner. As the name says, runner. Okay, you got the script ready, you got everything ready, but how you will be running? So again, now running part is different for different companies. You can use Jenkins, you can use TeamCity, you can use Bamboo, you can use any other CI server of your choice. In case if you don't want to use these CI tools, you can still run your test cases using Selenium Grid on different servers, on different systems, right? So runner part is totally different. And now these are the different components you need to explain in interviews. Now, if they ask you, can you explain further about your framework, like what are the set of tools you have used and what was your approach? Now here comes the main part. Now you need to explain each and everything in each component, what you used and how you used. So let's start from here. Test data, you can say, to maintain our test data, we are having all the data in Excel format. And in order to deal with Excel, we are using Apache POI. Okay, so using Apache POI, we are maintaining all the test data. And now we are using TestNG data provider, which pass the data in all our scripts. Here also, you can also mention that we are also using one properties file. Okay, so in the properties file, what we do, we maintain all the properties. We can maintain the browser, we can maintain the URL and other stuff. So you can say in the test data, basically you have two component. One is Excel, one is properties file, which is maintaining all the properties related to a project. Now in the report section, you can mention that for reporting, we are using, let's say, extent report or Allure report. Okay, so depends on which reporting utility you're using, you need to explain that this is the extent report we're using. And the extent report we have configured in the base class. So it is generating reports automatically. It is also having the screenshot automatically the moment our test is getting failed. So you need to explain now the reporting part. Now, as I mentioned in the utility, you can mention that in the utility, we have created a common class. Okay, in that we have all the common utilities that is getting consumed in our scripts again. So you can see this is also interconnected. Basically, in framework, everything is interconnected. It is just, I'm telling you like how we will be consuming it. Now, in this part, you can see in the scripting part, we are using one of the design pattern, okay, which is page object model, where we have pages and based on each page, we are creating the scripts and we are using TestNG as a unit test framework. And to maintain our project dependency, to build our project, we are using Maven. And using Maven pom.xml file, we are also triggering our scripts. And the last part, we are using Jenkins, which is running our automation test cases. Okay, so if you explain framework in this manner, what happens, you are actually telling them these are the tools you already know. Okay, so chances are very high that, see, throughout the in your framework explanation, let me write down how many things you're telling in interview. And chances are very high that your question will directly jump from non-technical to technical perspective. Okay, they will be more interested about the different tools that you're using in case if that guy is technical. So throughout this, you are in this process, you are explaining that you know Apache POI, right? You know a properties file, like how to read the properties file. You are telling how to use extent report or allure report. You're also telling that you know how to create custom utilities, which is a very important part, right? Utility. You're also telling that you know TestNG. Again, you might get a lot of questions from TestNG as well in interviews, right? Then again, you're telling you know design pattern, which is a very good point. So make sure when you are explaining, you read about page object model or single tool pattern, whatever pattern you are using, design pattern. Then you're also telling that you know Maven, right? And definitely throughout the session you know Selenium as well, because the complete framework that we are right now talking about is based on Selenium. So you know Selenium as well, right? Now in Maven you know how to trigger your XML files, and last you're also telling that you know Jenkins. And yeah, most important part, you need to also talk about where you are saving your code, okay? So you need to talk about the version control that you're using. So before coming to this runner part, okay, you can also add that we have all the source code on GitHub or GitLab, GitHub or lab, and then you're using this. So you internally also telling that you know about Git, you know about GitHub, and you know about GitLab as well, depends on which one you're using. And finally this is your runner. So chances are very high that you will be getting a lot of questions from this category, okay? And if you are really prepared, then you can easily answer all of these questions. How they're interconnected, how we are using it, I already covered in one of the video. If you go to my channel, you will find a video called Hybrid Framework in Selenium WebDriver. I have used all of this, and this complete flow I have covered. So please go through this video, that video which I have covered, Hybrid Framework Selenium WebDriver, complete flow I have covered. And yeah, this is how you can explain in interviews. Okay, so let me do a quick recap, then we will end this video. So when you start attending interviews, your answer should be, see, basically we are using Java as a programming language, and we are using hybrid framework. In this hybrid framework, we are using data driven and modular driven. Okay, so now for the data, then you come back and you explain that these are the different components we have in our framework. So we have a test data component which actually take care about the test data. In the test data, we have now two kind of data. One is test data, which is totally coming from the Excel file. One is the property file, which you can say is a config file. Then we have a separate component called reporting and logs. For reporting, we are using extent report or layer report. Then we have another component, which is utilities, which basically take care of all the standard basic utilities. Then we have the scripting part. For the scripting, we are using TestNG as a one of the unit test framework, which is JUnit or TestNG. We are using one of the design pattern called page object model. Using page object model, we have different pages, depends on how many HTML pages we have. We create our scripts based on that. And then you explain them about the Maven build, okay? That how you're using Maven. You're using project dependency for the project structure. And then you can also explain how you're running your TestNG scripts using Maven. And you can explain that we have this complete source code on one of the version control systems. You can explain about Git and GitHub. And then you can explain about we're using one of the CI server called Jenkins or Bamboo or TeamCity to run our automation test cases. Okay. So this is one answer you can give. Again, you don't have to be you don't have to get the exact same answer. You can, you know, change the order. You can change some set of, I will say, statements, but make sure you cover these basic components. How these components are interconnected, we have already discussed. In case if you don't know, please watch that video, which I already linked on the card here and in the description as well. That's all from my side, guys. In case if you have any other question, let me know in the comment section. And if you know any other better way to explain this framework, also just give me resources. I will look into that and I will try to make one more video on this. Okay. That's all from my side. Thank you so much, guys. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.